out of batteries.
I am finishing my nesting. I did this before I gave birth to him and I didn't finish up. And all these drawers are super dusty and gross. So I'm trying to vacuum everything out and then wipe down. But this is out of batteries. I'll just have to do it again later when I get back and then wipe down.
It didn't last too long, huh? I only did the car and that.
Yeah, I know.
This one's the older one. It's older than the one we have in LA.
Yeah, I know. So, but I mean, I'm glad that we have it still because all that dust was really overwhelming. That's why I was like, let's look for a maid. But I'm like, okay, here's my maid.
Maybe you don't need a maid now.
I know. And now I just wiped down because the dust was just overwhelming.
Did you clean all this? It looks clean.
Yeah, I did that, but I'm going to wipe it down. We're going to head back to LA right now. Give my brother some breather. Made some porridge for him there.
Congee.
Congee, that's right. Porridge is cereal and oats. No flavor. And congee has meat. Porridge doesn't have meat. Congee is rice. I just learned that, so don't be calling jiao porridge, it's kanji. Okay, let's go.
Such a great table, huh?
I know. It's a one of a kind table. Me and Brian built this together. If you guys didn't get a chance to see it, and you guys are just following now, check it out on this link up here. And hopefully, if you're up for it, then you can make one just like this.
It's held up well too, huh? Hmm? For how many years has it been?
Long, I don't know. I'll check.
5 years?
More than that. More than that.
Hmm.
We wanted it to look ash brown, but when we epoxied it, it turned to this brown. It's okay. I mean, it matches that. And it matches that. So. Anyways, I think we even wrote our names underneath.
I don't remember.
Yeah, we wrote our names underneath somewhere in here, and the only way that you could see it is if you go underneath, or if someone lifts this up and gets rid of it. So, for those losers who wants to re-renovate my house in 30 years and say this is old school, you'll see our names underneath.
So. I think no, it's under in the cabinet, so it's hidden.
Yeah, I think it's like something about Brian and Min or something like that, yeah. Alright. I think everything's cleaned. We always clean up after we leave. No, before we leave, we always clean this house and the other house. So, I think we're ready to go. I was gonna leave Brian to go to LA by himself, but then he felt lonely and he wants to see Scooper, even though he doesn't really hang out with Scooper. But trying my best to be a supportive wife, and hopefully my husband will be a supportive dad. We gotta pack everything, okay? Baby has to pack the whole house, you know? It's not like we can just take our stuff and then go. We have to pack everything. Diapers, clothes.
I don't, we have two places.
Donuts.
All right.
Okay, we cleared out this area, lots and lots of trash, and tomorrow's trash day, that's why. Baby's still not sleeping. It's already past 12. It's because your dad said to not wake you up, and I should have. Because now your whole sleeping schedule is messed up. It's okay. Let's go home. Put you down. Anyways, Brian cleaned out this area because it smelled like raw meat, because I went to Costco and the meat fell. The meat juices fell, so we had to clean it right away or else it's going to reek of blood. And, yeah. Let go, Nico. I'm gonna drive, because Brian's tired. It is gonna take an hour to get back home, and hopefully baby does not cry. I know sometimes he's really fussy in the car, and he starts crying hysterically. I already fed him, so that's good. And if he cries, it's probably because he's tired, and he has to sleep. So I'm gonna guess around 1 or 1:30 is when he starts to go. For now, it's about 12:30. Let go.
Hello.
He's starting. Home sweet home to a clean house. Okay, time to sleep. 1:30 a.m. We are waking up now, and I was breastfeeding this guy for a moment, and he was good and content. And, you know, after a while of breastfeeding, he starts to just, you know, use me as a pacifier. And then he bit me. He bit me so hard that his two little front teeth right here dug into my nipple and, like, kind of just sat in there. I had to yank him off because he was just, like, and moving his head back and forth. He was yanking my nipples. So I was like, ah! So I had to take it and unlatch it from his teeth. And, we have to start weaning you off, baby, for real. She's really, really starting to, like, bite everything. And so my nipples are bleeding. Actually, just nipple, my left nipple. My right one's okay for now. But look at him, big boy, guilty AF. Guilty. Yeah, you. You. Guilty. Hurts so bad, like, hurts. I could still feel the sting. But yeah, like, what do you do when baby starts biting you? And like, what if my boobs get engorged? I probably have to pump and dump because of all that blood. All right, we'll figure something out. Look at him. You know what you did. Don't look away. Baby is fussy, hungry. He only slept 1 hour today because he's naughty, naughty boy. Anyways, we're gonna feed him some mashed potatoes or sweet potatoes with some breast milk. So I had to pump because, you know, he bit me this morning, so not good. I'm gonna mix it in and bon appetit.